Hello guys and welcome to the channel everyone. In the previous video we created WordPress website in the local server. Now today I am going to show you how to make that local website to live. For this you need to download the plugin called all-in-one WP migration plugin in your local server. After this we need to export the file, and again we need to download the same plugin on our live website so that we can import that downloaded file. So to install the plugin, let's go to dashboard by clicking here. After that, click here on plugin and click on add new. Then search for the plugin, all-in-one WP migration plugin. Okay, so this is the plugin. After that, click here on install now. And then click here on activate. Okay, you can see our plugin has been installed and activated. So when you scroll down, you can see on the left hand side this all-in-one WP migration plugin. So click here so that we can export the file. Okay, and then select here on export, and then select here on file, because we are going to export it as file. Okay, now it will take some time. Okay, after that you can see download localhost. So this is our file, we need to download this, and the size is 106 MB. You can download it. So I'll click here on save. Okay, it is currently downloading. Okay, after downloading has finished, I'll click here on close. Okay, now the next step is to open the live website or WordPress dashboard so that we can import this downloaded file. Okay, for this I'll open the new tab and open my WordPress dashboard. This is the live WordPress. After that I'll click here on plugin and then click here on add new so that I can install and download that same plugin. Okay, I'll search for all-in-one WP migration plugin and then click here on install, and then click here on activate. So this is the plugin. On the left hand side you can see that plugin, but here we have to click here on import, because we are now going to import that file. You can see maximum file is 128 MB, and then I'll click here and then click here on file. Now select the file that you just downloaded from the local server. Okay, so this is the file, and then I'll click here on open. Okay, you can see the import process will overwrite your website, including the database, media, plugin and themes. Please ensure that you have a backup of your data before proceeding to the next step. Okay, click here on proceed, and then your data has imported successfully. You need to perform two more steps. The first one is you must save your permalinks structure twice. So click here. Now here you have to enter your old username and password that we created in the first video. If you remember, in the first video or in the local server, I created and I installed the WordPress. At that time, my username was this kiful123456, and I used the same password. Okay, so I'll copy and paste it here. And then click here on login. So after that, select this post name here, because it is the preferred one. Okay, after that scroll down and click here on save changes. Okay, this much. Now I'll close this. Now the second option is to review the plugin. If you want, you can review the plugin, you can give feedback to them. Okay, now let's go to our website to see whether it is imported correctly or not. So you can see this is our live website and it has been imported. So let's go down. So this is the title, product section, and this is the footer section. Okay, now I'll show you how to add products manually. To add the product, first let's go to the dashboard. On the left hand side you can see this product option, so click here and then click here on add new. Here you have to write the name for your product. I will write here jacket as the product name. Then you have to write here short description about the product, and then scroll down. Here you can see this product data section. Under this you can see simple product. First I will select this simple product. then you have to write the regular price. If you want to write the sale price, you can write here, and then go to inventory. You can write SKU if you want. SKU means unique code given to every product. Then write your stock status. Then write the weight for your product. I'll write 0.23 kg. Then write the dimensions for your product. Okay, after that, let's go to attribute. So attribute is for variable product. I'll show you that in the next part. Then again, write the short description for the product. And then let's scroll up. Here you can see set product image. So let's click here. Then you can upload the file or product image from here. Otherwise, you can also use from the media library if you want. Okay, I'll select this is the product image, and then click here on set product image. Now again, I'll click here on add product gallery image, and then I'll scroll down. After that, I'll select this image and click here on add to gallery. Okay, if you don't know why I'm adding the product gallery, okay, I'll show you that in the website. When you scroll down, when you see this product, when I over the mouse over this product, you can see this product image changes. So this is the animation given to every product. Okay, now you'll see this type of animation only when you add this product gallery images. Okay, after that, let's scroll up. Here you can see product categories. You can select the categories from here if you want. Otherwise, you can also add a new category. I will add new categories, and then click here on add new category. So category has been added. Now you can also write a product tax if you want. Okay, after that, click here on publish. Okay, you can see our product has been published. This is the link. So let's click on this link to see our product. So this is our product, and it has been published into our website. You can see the description, you can see the additional information, and under this you can see weight and dimensions. Okay, okay, so this was the simple product. Now I will show you how to add the variable product. For that, again, let's click here on add new under the product section. After that, give name to the product. I will write Keyful T-shirts, and then write the short description about the product. Then scroll down, then you can see a product data. Under product data, you can see simple product. So click here and select variable product. Then you can add the SKU if you want. It is the unique code given to every product. Okay, after that, go to shipping and write the weight for your product. I'll write here 0.5 kg. Then write the dimensions. Then go down and click here on attributes. Under this, click here on add. Attributes means sizes, colors, etc. Okay, then write the name for the attributes. I'll write here colors, and then don't forget to click here used for variation. Okay, after that, write the color. I'll write here purple, and give space, and write this separation bar, and then again write another color, and then click here on save attributes. Now let's add another attribute, that is size. Okay, first I'll tick here used for variation options, and then I'll write here size. Then under the value, I'll write yes for small and yum for medium size, and then click here on save attributes. Okay, now go to variations, and then click here, then select this create variation from our attributes, and then click here on go. After that, click on OK. Okay, now you can see all the attributes has been added, purple color and blue color, and sizes are small and medium. Then you have to upload the image for every colors. Okay, you can see there are two colors, so I have to upload the two images. Then you have to write the price for every product and every attribute. For this purple color, small size, I'll write $15. If you want, you can also write the weight and dimensions, but I will not write because we have already written earlier. Then for this second purple color, medium size, I'll write the price here is $20. And then for blue color, small size, I'll write here price of $15. And for this blue color, medium size, I'll write the price is $20. Okay, this much. After that, I'll click here on save changes. And then let's scroll up. Now I will add the product image. For this, I'll click here on set product image, and then I'll go to media library, and I'll select I'll select this image, and then click here on set product image. Okay, now I will add the product gallery image. For this, I'll click here, and then I'll select this image. After that, I'll click here on add to gallery. So I will add the product categories from here. I'll write here keyful t-shirts. Okay, after that I'll click here add new gallery. Okay, after that I'll click here on publish. Okay, I forget to write the short description, so I'll write here, and then I'll click here on update. So I'll go to this link, our product link, to see how our product looks like. So this is our product and it has been published into our website. So in this way you can add simple product and variable product in your website. Now I'll show you how to display the product on your website using the WooCommerce shortcut. For this, let me open the new tab and go to the website. After that I'll scroll down and I'll show you how to display the product in the same way. You can see here. Okay, for this I'll click here on edit with Elementor, and then it will take me to the Elementor page. After that I'll again scroll down. After that I'll remove this section. Okay, I think it is not necessary, so I'll remove this, and then I'll duplicate this whole section. To duplicate it, I'll right click here. After that I'll click here on duplicate. You can see whole section has been duplicated. Now first I'll change this text. You can see here this new arrivals. So I'll first remove this text from here, and then I'll write here trending products. Okay, after that, in order to change the images, first I need to click here on blue button. After that, on the left hand side you can see this enter your shortcode option. Okay, first I'll open the new tab and go to this website. I'll provide this link in the description. Actually this is the documentation page of WooCommerce, where you can learn about the shortcut of WooCommerce. Okay, you can see our product section, so we'll use this product shortcode for the WooCommerce. Okay, you can use the shortcode for featured product, sell product, best selling product, recent product, and product attribute and top rated product. But in this video I'll show you how to use the shortcode for ID and for the product that are listed on the basis of categories. Okay, you can see our categories, comma separated list of category slugs. So I'll scroll down and I'll search for the shortcode on the basis of category, or I'll search for the category shortcode. Okay, you can see here under scenario 5, under this specific category section. So this is the category shortcut. So I'll copy this and I'll go to the Elementor page and I'll paste it here, and I'll remove this hoodies category and I'll write here my own category. Okay, if you remember, I made the category named keyful jacket earlier, so I'll write here keyful jacket, and I also made keyful t-shirts, so I'll remove it and I'll write here keyful t-shirts as the category name. Now after that you can see here the product has not been displayed, so I'll remove this A and D end letter and I'll write here I and in. Okay, finally the product is seen. So you can see the category name keyful t-shirts and keyful jacket. Now if you want to change this column, you can also change it, and I'll write here two, so that only two product will be seen. So there is already a woman product listed on this website, so I'll write here woman. Okay, I'll write here woman as the category name. Okay, after that the products that are listed under the woman categories will be displayed. When you scroll down you can see our total 8 products, because you can see our under the shortcode you can see product limit is equal to 8, so the 8 product are displayed. You can change this and you can write here 4, so that only 4 product will be displayed. Okay, again I'll remove this and I'll write here 3. Okay, and under the column I'll also remove it and I'll write here 3, so that product limit is equal to 3 and columns is equal to 3. Okay, after that I'll click here on apply, and then I'll scroll up. So these are the product that are listed on the basis of categories, and then I'll click here on update. Now I'll show you how to display the product on the basis of ID. For this, again I'll click here on duplicate to duplicate the whole section. Okay, after that when I scroll down, you can see here the same section has been duplicated. So in order to change the product, click here on blue button, and on the left hand side you can use the shortcut to change the product. First I'll remove this. Okay, now here I'll add my own shortcut for the product. Product columns is equal to then I'll write here 3, because I want 3 column to be displayed. After that I'll write here order by is equal to title, and then id is equal to, so here I have to write the product id. If you don't know where you can find the product id, let me go to the dashboard first. So I'll click here on dashboard. Okay, after that on the left hand side you can see product, and I'll click here on all product. So here before the product you can see the id for the product. Okay, so these are the ids. So I'll copy this id number 84, and I go to the Elementor and I'll paste it here, and then I'll write here comma. Again I'll go to the product page, and then I'll scroll down. After that I'll copy this id number 79, and then I'll paste it here. Again I'll write comma and go to the product page. After that I'll select this id number 53, and then I'll write here 53, and then I'll write inverted comma and then square bracket. So you can see the product has been displayed on the basis of id. I will again go to the product page, and I will select I think this last product 47 id number. After that I will write here 47. Now I have to change this product column number, and I will write here 4, so that the 4 product will be displayed in this section. Okay, in this way you can use shortcut for the product to be displayed in your website. After that I'll click here on update. Okay, after that I'll scroll up. So these are the product that are displayed on the basis of id, and these are the product that are displayed on the basis of categories. Okay, so in this way you can use WooCommerce shortcode to display your product on the basis of IDs, categories, or featured product or sale product in your website. In the next video, I'll show you how to import the product from AliExpress using the free plugin.